New at 6, social media is leading to a global obsession with the way people look.
And we're talking kind of about digital vanity, and Color 10's Melissa Stern is here to show you what some people are doing about it.
You could call it the Facebook facelift. With the everyday use of Twitter, Instagram, and Skype, more people are seeing themselves and a magnified view of themselves more often. This causes them to notice their flaws, giving plastic surgeons more and more clientele.
I'll just take a glance and I'll be like, please don't post that.
We're all guilty of it.
And I think, do I look like that?
We're living in a digital world, and what gets posted on the internet stays on the internet.
Anyone can take a photo and it's on Facebook.
Lana Vincent is in her 40s. She uses social media all the time, and it makes her more conscious of her flaws.
It has made me start questioning, you know, what are the new procedures out there? What can be done?
People sometimes notice that and say, you know, when you see me, I want to make sure that they don't see this or that.
Dr. Bharat Shah is a plastic surgeon. He says more patients are coming in after seeing themselves digitally.
It's just crystal clear, and every imperfection shows up.
He says it's because with all the technology out there, people can view themselves in a way they couldn't just a few years ago.
People really want to look their best because their faces out there now. It's not just in the family album anymore. It's broadcast across the internet.
All my friends the same age, they're all, you know, have the same concerns.
Many of Dr. Shah's patients decide they want to make some changes, especially now because of the wide range of procedures.
Botox or fillers, just to kind of tune things up, skin laser resurfacing, or maybe a facelift. It really just depends on what changes you want to make.
I would like to look the best that I could look for my age. I don't care if people know what I've had done. It's maintenance.
Dr. Shah says nationally the procedure that's increased the most percentage-wise is chin implants. He says the numbers in general are increasing because of non-invasive treatments. Now you can have a lot done without going under the knife.
Interesting stuff, Melissa. Thanks.